Look, I know everybody who is watching this video right now probably does not like the fact that I'm bringing up this topic. And that's understandable. Don't worry, I totally get it, because in theory, in morality, in common practice, this topic that we're talking about should never be the case. In theory, if you're a fan of a sports team, you want your team to win. And a situation like the 2020 Stanley Cup Play-In Series should be an opportunity where fans can come together and cheer for the teams that they like to win. Not really to lose. But the fact of the matter is, the idea of tanking for Alexis Lafreniere because a play-in series loser pick has won the first overall spot in the 2020 NHL Entry Draft does indeed exist, and it's something that many fan bases have spoken about pretty much in all of their separate discourses, and you cannot tell me that I'm wrong about that. So, just for context, this is the 2020 Stanley Cup play-in chart as we have it. On the east, we have Toronto, Columbus, Pittsburgh, Montreal, the Islanders and the Panthers, and the Rangers and the Hurricanes. On the west side, we have Calgary, Winnipeg, Edmonton, Chicago, Vancouver, Minnesota, and Arizona, Nashville. The thing is, every single one of these play-in teams, they'll have the opportunity to keep their first-round pick in the 2020 NHL Draft. At least, that is to my understanding. I am recording this video at 1 a.m. in the morning, July 11th, Pacific Standard Time, so if something comes out later tomorrow, before this video is uploaded about 8 hours from now, then I apologize. But, to my understanding, every single one of these teams has the ability to win Alexis Lafreniere because all the conditional picks that have been traded actually have the ability to go back to their teams. We have question marks for the Arizona Coyotes because their first round pick currently belongs to the Devils, but if that first round pick is in the top three, then it goes back to Arizona. Vancouver has somewhat of a similar situation. Their clause was whether or not they make the playoffs, which, yesterday, there was a big scare as to whether or not the Canucks being in the play-in series actually means they're in the playoffs. For statistical purposes, people are saying that the stats and the goals and all that is going to count as playoff stats, but for now, to many people's understanding, the Vancouver Canucks first-round pick is not officially New Jersey's yet, but it is Vancouver's to lose if they eventually win against the Minnesota Wild. Furthermore, we also have the Toronto Maple Leafs, who, yeah, no, their first round pick belongs to the Carolina Hurricanes, but there is a similar top three clause there. If the Toronto first ends up being a top three pick, it will go back to Toronto. The Islanders have the exact same situation with their pick that currently belongs to the Ottawa Senators. We have the Carolina Hurricanes, whose first round pick belongs to the Rangers, who they're actually playing. But the thing is, the Carolina Hurricanes' condition is that the Rangers will receive the lesser of the Toronto and the Carolina pick. If the Toronto pick ends up winning first overall, then the Carolina Hurricanes, I don't know what's actually going to happen there, but they won't actually win the pick, obviously, because it would have been Toronto's pick that would have won. But if it's the Carolina first that actually wins, then the New York Rangers would receive what would have been Toronto's first-round pick, because if Carolina wins the lottery, it means that Toronto didn't win the lottery, which means that Toronto's pick ends up going to Carolina, which would then go to New York because Carolina would be giving the lesser of the two firsts. It's complicated, I know, but that's pretty much how it goes down. We also have a few more. The Pittsburgh Penguins do indeed have a first-round pick belonging to the Minnesota Wild, but similar to the Vancouver Canucks, if the Pittsburgh Penguins miss the 2020 playoffs, which, for the sake of this video, we're going to say that means they don't win their play-in series against the Habs, then they have the option to choose whether or not they want to give up this year's pick or next year's pick. Whether or not that's before or after the draft lottery, I'm not too sure, but there's a chance that they say, yep, we lost against the Habs. We'll keep our pick for this year. Thank you very much, Minnesota. And then it wins first overall. So every single team, virtually speaking, in the play-in series has the opportunity to win Alexis Lafreniere, taking into account all the stipulations, all the conditions on the trades, and every possibility that does exist. Because all the teams that lose will get an equal 1-in-8 shot at getting the first overall pick, which is why tanking for Lafreniere has been something that every single fan base of every one of these teams has discussed. And I know I'm absolutely right on that fact. But before we get any further, let's just establish that yes, tanking does exist within the fans' perception of how the game is played. But tanking is never going to actually be a product that you see out there on the ice. Sure, the Montreal Canadiens are not a good team, and they're not going to beat the Pittsburgh Penguins, or at least that's what I think. But there's no way the Montreal Canadiens are going to go out there and purposefully try to lose because they want a 1-8 opportunity at getting the French superstar that's going to be available in the draft. That's just not going to happen. You're not going to be able to convince players to play worse because it's in the organization's best interest to get a high pick in the 2020 draft rather than go further in the playoffs and have your draft pick go down to 15 or 16. That's not ethical and it's not going to happen. It's just, as fans, we can talk about whether or not we would prefer the teams that we cheer for to win or to lose. The Montreal thing comes to play because, hey, what do the Canadiens have to gain from getting swept by either the Flyers, the Lightning, the Capitals, or the Bruins after miraculously defeating the Pittsburgh Penguins? There's no way this Canadiens team is good enough to make a run. So what's the point of cheering for them to do that when you could cheer for them to lose and end up getting Lafreniere? And it's something that almost every other fan base that I've seen has talked about. The Vancouver Canucks one, it comes to mind especially because, hey, the Canucks have dropped in the lottery so much that maybe, just maybe, things could go in their favor once. The Minnesota Wild, on the other hand, the team that the Canucks are facing, I've seen their fan base cheering over and over again to get Lafreniere too. Look at this poll over here from Michael Russo on Twitter. People want him to suit up in net because it will make their team lose. People have talked about the Toronto Maple Leafs maybe losing. Hey, if we lose to the Blue Jackets, I wouldn't be too upset. A 1-8 chance at Lafreniere seems amazing to play alongside of Austin Matthews. That's going to be cap hell the minute Alexis Lafreniere signs the deal after his entry level, but it would make for a very entertaining first few years. The Blue Jackets are a team who, to me, absolutely would deserve a Lafreniere. We talked about this in the video talking about how Lafreniere would go to one of the 8 worst teams in the conference if the play-in series get canceled, but the Blue Jackets were not supposed to be here. They weren't supposed to be good. They lost Panarin, DeZingle, Bobrovsky, Duchesne, everybody who was good in Columbus and had the option to leave ended up leaving. But they're still up in here, still competitive, still doing well, and without the star power of a Panarin and a Duchesne and a Bobrovsky. Sure, they've got star power in Marinsky and Jones and Dubois, I get that, but you lost out on Panarin. I think you guys deserve a little bit more. As for the Pittsburgh Penguins, well, nobody in Pittsburgh is cheering for Alexis Lafreniere. They're just cheering for the satisfaction they'll get if they get that pick, because the rest of the league will be salty, and I absolutely agree with that. As for the Islanders, well, you know what? The Islanders-Panthers series, it goes either way. Both of these fan bases are in a position where if they win, okay, you're in the playoffs, great. But if you lose, hey, 1-8 chance at Lafreniere, that certainly wouldn't be bad either. And for the Carolina Hurricanes and the Rangers, well, the Rangers, they were supposed to be in a rebuild. I don't know how the heck they ended up in here. The Carolina Hurricanes are supposed to be good, though. But if they end up losing because Brady Shea ultimately does something dumb, then Lafreniere, Aho, Svechnikov sounds like a deadly, deadly line. The Flames and the Jets, hey, the Jets are in a position where they could definitely benefit from a Lafreniere because they had somewhat of a down year. The Flames could use a little bit more of that star power because the doubters are starting to come in here a little bit more. Calgary is not the powerhouse that people thought they would be at this point like 2 years ago. Edmonton-Chicago, Edmonton does not need any more first overall picks, but they would be so, so happy if they got it because, again, like Pittsburgh, the rest of the league would just explode out of their minds. For Chicago, again, it's the same point. They could totally use an opportunity like this because their forward core going into the next few years is not as solidified as it was in the past. And sure, they do have a historical record of winning over and over and over again, but those days are over. The future transition into youth is starting up, and Alexis Lafreniere could be a huge push in that direction. As for the Nashville Predators, well, you know what? They're kind of in the same boat as the Coyotes. If you win, hey, you're in the postseason. And if you lose, hey, you got a 1-8 shot at Lafreniere. Every single one of these teams has that option, but obviously none of them are actually going to purposefully tank. It's just really funny to me how every single fan base, even if they don't really need the pick, will go into such a detailed analysis as to what would happen if they did get the pick and if they actually lost. It gives all these teams something to be happy about if they lose, which maybe is a very good piece of medicine for the NHL and its fan bases, but at the same time, it's absolute anger fuel for the teams like Detroit and Ottawa and LA. Actually, not LA. You guys got a second overall pick. You're good. So, comment down below what you think about the NHL and the tanking that people have been talking about. Obviously, that's not going to happen purposefully, but the fans can definitely change whatever narratives they want and talk about things in a way that suits what they believe. So, tell me all about that in the comment section below. If you're a fan of a play-in series team, what would Alexis Lafreniere do for your franchise? Tell me all about that. I hope you enjoyed this video. Search that Trolls99. And bye.